Most late model vehicles have an average of 60 to 100 sensors on board. But due to the rapid advancement of automotive technology, the number of sensors is projected to reach up to 200 per car in the next few years. The internal combustion engine is increasingly controlled by smart sensors that feed data to multiple onboard computers. Oxygen sensors, for example, are vital to an internal combustion engine because of their role in controlling the fuel injection system and emissions. In the OBD2 era, all 1996 and newer vehicles have at least two oxygen sensors, which measure the oxygen content in the exhaust. As the oxygen sensor has evolved over the past 40 years, engineers have made the component sense a more extensive range of rich and lean conditions while also detecting small changes in oxygen content sooner. Some modern air fuel sensors are so sensitive that they can detect tiny leaks in the exhaust manifold. Typically, oxygen sensors won't last the life of a vehicle. A telltale sign of a bad O2 sensor is black exhaust smoke, which can indicate a too rich air-fuel mixture. A mass airflow sensor, just as the name implies, measures the volume and density of air entering the engine at any given time. The engine control unit, or ECU, uses this information along with input from other sensors to calculate the correct amount of fuel to deliver to the engine. Data from this sensor helps calculate ignition timing and transmission shifting strategies. A failing mass airflow sensor can cause too rich or too lean combustion, which could result in black exhaust smoke, a rough running engine, or a deterioration in fuel economy. The manifold absolute pressure sensor, or MAP sensor for short, measures the atmospheric pressure inside the intake manifold and relays the information to the ECU. The information, along with readings from other engine sensors, helps adjust for the correct air-fuel ratio. A failing MAP sensor also can contribute to a too rich or too lean running engine, which can manifest itself in rough idling, reduced engine power, and stalling, among other symptoms. The last type of sensor we're going to cover is the vehicle speed sensor, also known as the engine speed sensor. The vehicle speed sensor, or VSS, monitors how fast the engine's crankshaft is spinning. The information from this sensor helps manage shifting points, regulate the air-fuel mixture, and control the speedometer, as well as assist in some advanced engine functions, such as cylinder deactivation. On some vehicles, the transmission speed sensor is used in place of the VSS. A number of symptoms can point to a bad VSS, including irregular shift timing, a malfunctioning speedometer, or issues with the anti-lock braking system. Obviously, we've just scratched the surface here. In future videos, we'll take a look at other sensors and their roles in the vehicle. I'm Josh Cable. Thanks for watching.